Kumusta po, Bishop? Is brought to you by the Archdiocese of Cáceres, Cáceres Commission on Communications, Cáceres Renewal Communities, PBN-TV5 DZOK 97.5, GNN Naga Channel 48, 98.3 FM The Mother's Touch, 24K Jewelry and Pawn Shop, FINMA Foundation, University of Northeastern Philippines.
Ito na naman, linggo na naman ng umaga. Meron na naman bagong mapapanood na programa. Siguradong bago to dito sa Kabikola. Pagkat dito si Arsobispo mismo ang sa atin
Marhay na aldaw sa Indoga Boss mga tugang, asin, kumusta po kamo? Saro na naman ang episode kan sa tuyang programa, igdi po sa kumusta po Bishop, ang sa Indong madadalan, mahihinan nyo, mga nakaka-inspirar na istorya, mga aktibidades kan sa tuyang Arsobispo, asin man istorya, kan compassionate Franciscan Sisters of the Poor. Ako po si Tess Bañares Delphine, inipoan, kumusta po Bishop?
Kiraray, Diyos marhay na aldaw sa Idugobus. Tugang, welcome to our show. Kamusta po, Bishop? Isang oras ng pagbabalitaan natin, pagkakamustahan. At siyempre, babalita ko sa inyo ang aking mga gigibuhin sa mga darating na araw na ito. At lalong-lalo na yung test yung aking mararanasan this coming June 29. Tatanggapin ko yung pallium. Ano ba yung pallium test? Yan ang stola. Yes, so ano? Natatanggapin ko from our Holy Father. So, makasama po kayo sa amin sa isang oras ng ating programang Kamusta Po, Bishop?
Bishop, marahin na aldaw sa imo and we welcome once again ang satuyang bisita at siyang papabisto
yes,
ko
sure,
siya
formally, welcome.
Bishop. Oo. Si Mother Jo Ann Claire. Bishop, nagkakaroon tayo ngayon ng parang advance taping of our Kumusta Po, Bishop program.
Okay.
Because ikaw po ay aalis at ikaw po ay bibigyan ng sinasabi mo kaninang pallium
yes,
ng ating
yes,
Santo Papa. Mag-i-explain ngayon si Bishop sa ate, sa lahat ng ating mga tagapanood kung ano po ang pallium.
Alam niyo po sa grasya ng Diyos at sa kagandang loob ng Santa Sede, ako po ay hinirang bilang Archbishop, Fourth Archbishop, digdi sa ating Archdiocese ng Cáceres. Kapag ang isang obispo ay nagginawang Archbishop, pinagkakalooban siya ng pallium. Yung pallium ay isang uri ng stola na isinusuot galing yun sa wool ng mga tupa, ng sheep. Ginaginigibok ang mga madre.
It's a very special.
Yeah, ang mga stola. Sisters ang gumagawa nito. And then, inilalagay ito sa tomb ni St. Peter. And then, pag dumating yung feast ng Solemnity of St. Peter and St. Paul, which is June 29. Yes, no? Sa Vatican, ang mga archbishop, newly appointed archbishops from all over the world, sa gabos ka munduhan, pupunta sa Roma. Okay? At during the Mass, either bago magmisa, isinusuot ng Santo Papa yung pallium.
So, yun ang pinakamilisan, Bishop, kung kayo aalis.
Yes, meron tatlong cross. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng pallium?
Pallium.
My dear friend, itong pallium po ay nagsasagisag ng katapatan o fidelity. Expression ng fidelity ng Arsobispo sa Santo Papa at sa tinatawag nating Holy See. Isa kabuuan ng ating inang simbahan. So, ito ay parang isang pledge ng Archbishop na magiging tapat siya sa Santo Papa at sa ating inang simbahan. Katulad ng mga kardinal naman, sila pula ang suot. Ibig sabihin niyang pula ay andahan nilang ibuhos ang kanilang dugo.
Eh, usually, Bishop, anong kulay yung palyo na ibibigay? Puti,
it's white. It's white. Yung Santo Papa nating Emeritus, medyo naiba yung kanyang palyo, eh. Naging may mga style. Pero ngayon, ang ating present Pope, yung traditional na dito. Na ganun, ha? Eh, nung una nga naalaman ko yung palyo, ano may palyo? Tinignan ko sa internet. Marami kong natutunan doon. You know, talagang maganda. Pero, siyempre ako, personally, as I said, by the grace of God, because nobody's worthy, no? To be given this title by the grace of God and the favor of the Holy See, very emotional to eh. Para bagang, siyempre, as padi, as obispo, as archbishop, isa lang naman talaga ang motivation namin eh. Di ba, sister, no? Just to serve Jesus and serve the church, no? Yung mga, in a way, we call it ecclesiastical titles. Title na archbishop, title na cardinal, you know? Pero mahalaga yung fidelity mo sa paglilikod mo sa itong kagurangan kay Jesus. Yun ang mahalaga.
Ikaw lang po ba, Bishop, ang bibigyan yan? Mula sa Pilipinas? Or alam
mo, ito nga magandang sister, very historical. Ako ang huling in-appoint ng ating Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI as Archbishop sa Pilipinas.
Okay.
At ako naman ang magiging una. Makakatanggap ng palyo sa bagong
Pope.
Si Pope Francis. Yes, no? Kaya nga sabi ko, well, this is very interesting, you know, na para bagang nakadalawang papa ako.
Yung
nagbigay sa akin ng
appointment.
And then the one who will confer upon me itong palium na ito.
And that's the main reason bakit pupunta po kayo
Yes, pupunta ako sa Roma. And normally, pag pumunta ang Archbishop doon, siyempre, nagsasama na rin siya ng pilgrims.
I see.
Hindi to tour. This is a religious experience. Religious event. Kaya, actually, mag-i-start kami sa Prague. Yung grupo namin, 25 kami. Why Prague? Alam mo ako, devoted ako sa Santo Niño.
That's in Germany.
No, in Czech Republic. Yes, as a Czech Republic. Yung Santo Niño ay Infant Jesus of Prague. Yun ang dinala dito, ang kanyang shrine dito sa Montserrat, sa San Beda, no? Pero lumaganap dito sa atin. Of course, meron tayo sa Antonio de Cebu, iba-iba. De Binondo, iba-iba. O de Tondo, iba-iba yan. Pero ang talagang naging well-known all over the world, no, ay yung Santo Niño, Infant Jesus of Prague. Na it was given by Spanish princess sa mga Carmelites. Ang mga Carmelite ang nag-spread ng devotion sa Europe. Kaya ako'y Carmelite, di ba?
Oh, yes.
Kaya very close ako sa Santo Niño. In fact, sa logo ko, makikita doon sa logo ko ang image ng Santo Niño. So from sa Prague, magpipilgrimage kami sa shrine ng Infant Jesus of Prague. And then from there, tutuloy na kami sa Rome. For this big event.
So you're together with ilang Pilipino bishop?
15 coming from the Philippines, but some of my friends from Australia, I think,
Tatlo sila. Will also be joined.
Yes, my sister and my niece from the States.
Okay.
And I have some friends from Switzerland who will join, will come for that event. And also one from Ireland, pupunta rin. At isa from Croatia.
So, bali, Bishop, sila'y magwi-witness na rin.
Yes.
So, napakatahalagang bahagi.
Well, some of them will join the entire pilgrimage. Yes. Kasi from Rome, we will go to Lourdes and Fatima.
Oh, yeah. Uh-oh.
So, you notice na, from Infant Jesus, tapos sa Roma, and then yung mga pilgrim sites ng Lourdes at Fatima, places na very close sa ating mga Pilipino. At later on, I'll be going to some friends para sa tulong sa mga funding agency, you know, sa dati yung mga projects sa Infanta, sa Switzerland, and sa Ireland also.
From Rome, Bishop, ilang oras pa din po ba yung papunta ng Lourdes, France? Malapit
By plane pa din. Actually, magpe-plane kami. Hindi naman malayo yan. Oh. Anyway, dito sa isa pa reception ng pallium.
Oh, yes.
I think it would be, I really do not know the entire ceremony muna. No? Nag-iba kasi bagong pope natin ngayon.
Yes.
No? From what I gather, baka ito yung gagawin sa St. Peter's, no, sa
Basilica, sa Basilica.
Yeah, not inside the church, outside, you know. Kasi maraming tao to, big celebration to.
Oh, what a religious and big celebration.
So I would know there would be archbishops from the States, from other countries, but ilang kami exactly, I really did not know. Kaya eh, pinagdadala kami ng aming formal dress, yung pusya, ayong pusya. Kaya mabigat sa maleta yung test eh.
Siguro, Bishop, in our next episode, si-update nyo na lang po kaming lahat ang ating mga kapanood sa kumusta.
Sasabi ko nga pala si Father Erwin, you know, na...
Kung ano mga nangyari talaga actual doon sa pag-receive.
At saka, hindi naman sa, no, this event, I mean, this experience, this honor, if you like, is not for me personally. It's the Archdiocese. Eh, dala-dala ko ang pangalan ng Archdiocese. Mm-hmm. Para makikilala talaga sa buong simbahan ang Archdiocese of Cáceres. Na, of course, kilala na tayo with ang sa ating Bishop Emeritus, Legazpi. Kilala yan sa Vatican, eh, si Archbishop Legazpi. No? Eh, ngayon, ako naman, manggagaling dito rin bilang kanyang successor. So, it would really be a big honor for the Archdiocese of Cáceres.
Sana nga, Bishop, may sarili kang cameraman doon. Nakasama yung kumusta po, Bishop Tim. For that purpose, ano?
Oo ka.
Malas ang kamay ni Roger.
Oo ka. Mag-apit tayo sa ating mga nanonood. Yes, baka may gusto mong bigay ng extra ticket dyan.
Okay.
Yeah.
How will you best describe St. Peter's Basilica and even its surroundings, Bishop?
You know, Tess, I have been blessed, ba? Yes. No? Mm-hmm. Ako'y pumunta sa Roma when I was, 1970.
Oh.
1970. Mm-hmm. Ah, nandun ako. I studied in Rome for 6 years. Anin mo tayo na ako sa Roma, doon ako nag-theology.
Philosophy,
hindi. Philosophy dito. Theology sa Roma, at saka yun lang, well, masteral studies. Yes. No?
And doon ka din in-ordain, hindi po.
Doon ako in-ordain 1974. Kaya medyo kabisado kong ang Roma.
Oo. No?
Eh, napakagandang lugar. Siyempre, yung Vatican. You know? Iba talaga yung St. Peter's Basilica eh. Yung mother ng ating mga oldie churches, no? Pag nandun ka sa loob, iba talaga ang feeling mo. Lalo na pag Sunday, nag-attend kami ng Angelus ng Holy Father, you really feel the universal church. And you see all kinds of people, you know, of all races, all kinds of religions, all kinds of priests. Yun ang maganda sa ating mga Katoliko, we have a center. Meron tayong center. No, of our expression of our faith.
Yes. No? And that's St. Peter.
Yes, St. Peter. Isang hindi ko makakalimutan, no, ako yung first na pumunta sa Rome, that was in 1970, as I said. It was also the time na ginawang Doctor of the Church si Santa Teresa of Avila, ang aming foundress. So ako yung nagsirbi, ako ay acolyte, kaya nag-rehearsal kami,
we had a
rehearsal sister. At ako yung nagbuhos ng tubig sa kamay ni
Pope Paul VI.
I was so excited na binibilang ko yung Donald ng Pope Paul VI.
It's very historical.
Yeah. 1970 yun.
And acolyte ka during the High Mass.
Marami kami, marami. Pero ako isa lababo. Inugasay ng kami.
Oh, imagine.
So yung Papa, titignan ko talaga, excited ako.
Ay, kung i-research mo pala, Bishop, yung CD yun noon, or naandun ka?
Hindi ko alam kung may CD na
nun. Wala pa
yata. Wala pa siguro. Tape recorder pa lang.
Bakit sa history book, andun na. Ito yung mga kasali.
Pero hindi ko makakalimutan noon, you know. Talagang pinag-rehearsal kami, very formal.
Opo.
At saka noon, bawal magkamot, bawal gumiti, bawal talaga. Very serious.
Paano, Bishop, kung kagating ka na ng langgam, hindi ka talaga...
Hindi, lahat naman ang langgam doon, katoliko na.
Mababait ang langgam doon.
Mababait ang langgam doon. Eh kaya, at saka, ang magkagandaan sa ang Rome, you know, yan ay center din ng mga studies na maraming mga seminarista at pare. Nandiyan ang mga talagang well-known universities. Well-known. Pero alam mo, Tess, siguro bago ko ituloy yan, mabuting mag-break muna tayo. At kung po kayo alis sa aming programang Kamusta Po?
Halika't magkipagkwentuhan ka na. Kumusta po, Bishop? Kumusta?
Kumusta po, Bishop is also brought to you by Bob Marlin Restaurant, Gold Print Publishing House, Starmark Royal, Moraville Hotel and Restaurant,
Deca Homes,
Ateneo de Naga University. We appeal to our listeners and viewers to support this project. please send your donation to the Archbishop's residence or the CCCOM office, 473-8483-472-5665.
66th year of quality Catholic education, the Baga Parochial School is now accepting girls from preschool to grade 7. Now with Co-Ed High School, grade 7. I'm glad you
came. Kumusta po, Bishop? Is brought to you by the Archdiocese of Cáceres, Cáceres Commission on Communications, Cáceres Renewal Communities, PBN-TV5 DZOK 97.5, GNN Naga Channel 48, 98.3 FM The Mother's Touch, 24K Jewelry and Pawn Shop, FINMA Foundation, University of Northeastern Philippines.
Nagpapadagos po sa kuyang programa, kumusta po, Bishop? Bishop, kanina nabanggit po na ang Roma ay sentro ng mga religious studies, theology, philosophy.
Yes, oh,
And napakaswerte niyo po, Bishop, dahil isa po kayo sa naging estudyante ng college.
Well, talagang sasabihin ko yung biyaya ng Panginoon, the Lord, no? Blessing ng God, na napadala ka ng aming congregation sa Roma. Pero sa Rome, marami talaga mga well-known universities. No? Dominican, Angelicum, Saliturgy, Ancilianum, mga Benedictine, Carmelites, Spirituality, yung Gregorian University ng mga Jesuits.
So, Bishop, know? Almost lahat na ng congregation meron
silang... Yes, so, talagang complete university yan. Kaya, seminarians or priests from other dioceses of the world, you know, nagpapadala doon. Even yung propaganda fide, no? At mga centers for training missionaries,
ay, doon din.
Doon din pinadadala, no? At marami. Kaya marami tayong mga misyonero nang galing na doon. But you know, kasi ang church, by its very nature, misyonero yan eh.
Yes.
Kaya mga mapswerte tayo na meron tayong missionary.
Oh, yes.
Pakilala mo kasi si Sister.
Okay.
Sige.
Mga tugang, orgulyo mi pong ipapabisto sa Indo ang sabuyang bisita. Naghahali po sa Compassionate Franciscan Sisters of the Poor. Si Mother Joanne Claire Chen Loy, ang founder po kang nasabing kongregasyon. Good day to you, Sister.
Thank you very much.
Oh yeah, and you probably would like to greet our audience watching all of us now.
I'm very happy to be here to speak with you. But first of all, I'm sorry I can't understand all that you're saying.
Sorry, it's okay,
because
Sister,
I
yes.
really wish I knew what you were saying. But I get the gist of it from the bishop and from Archbishop and from you.
Yep. Thank you.
But to set things straight, I feel like a celebrity.
Oh, of course,
I
yes.
came to work with the poor, and I'm here sitting with celebrity.
Yeah.
Mother Joanne.
The other thing, the second thing there is that I really call myself Sister Joan Claire.
Oh, yeah.
We're Franciscan sisters.
Yeah.
And Archbishop did say, Archbishop Agaspi, your mother, I said, yes, Archbishop, but we're all sisters.
Yes.
And I wouldn't mind if you called me Sister Joan Claire. It's okay. If you wish to say Mother Joan Claire as a distinction, well, fine, but
yeah.
I am still one of
yes,
many
yes,
sisters. I'm
right.
a Sister Joan Claire.
Actually, Sister, we're all brothers and sisters in the Lord, right?
Correct.
Yes. But you know, Sister, I'm so happy to meet you again, you know. You know, Sister has a group.
Yes, Bishop.
Especially very much connected with the Knights of Columbus. They're also helping the poor, mm-hmm, you know. Mm-hmm. And I'm very grateful to Sister because one time I said, Sister, the mother of my former alalay, you know, in Tumutulo sa akin, needed a wheelchair. And this poor lady couldn't stand, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I mentioned this to her. And I thought she forgot all about it. Ano? Alam ko po, nakalimutan na niya. But after a few months, she came with this Knights of Columbus,
yes.
you know, from the States, huh? They brought the wheelchair. And you know what? The biggest surprise, ito po mga tugang, talagang magugulat kayo. Sa bagay, marami sa inyo, hindi pa siguro pinapanganak noon. Ang nagdala po ng wheelchair, the one who brought the wheelchair, ay anak ni Jerry Lewis. Do you know Jerry Lewis? Yung comedian.
Comedian.
Nabibisto ang edad ko, no? 94 gati, no?
Comedian siya, Bishop.
And Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis.
Yun.
Ay, yung mga
silang
nanonood
dalawa
po.
Ang partners.
Ay, marami sa atin, nanonood ng mga minamahal natin, mga senior citizen, katulad
hindi
ko.
Hindi na sila kilala ng kabataan.
Oh, hindi na kilala ng kabataan. Pero when I found out, nung nalaman ko, I said, are you kidding?
Yeah.
Sabi, no, I'm really, I'm really the son. Yeah. But you know, he said, your dad, I always follow your dad. I mean, when every time he's in the movie, I would watch his movies, yeah. Also television, and TV no, black and white pa. Diba? Black and white pa TV no, ano?
Kaya, so very active yung anak ni Mr. Louis.
Yes, very active. Oh. And then sabi niya, Bishop, you email my dad, and he will send you a picture.
Still alive.
Yeah, yeah. Oh. He is in his 90s. Right? No, he's no. So he will write and make his signature. When I email pa ako, wala pa sagot eh.
But you were very happy sitting in the wheelchair. You look very cute.
Oh yes, I sat on the wheelchair. Sabi ko, ano ba to? Turbo, parang Ferrari. Yeah. Huh? You know? Anyway, sister, yeah. We're so glad to have you here. Yeah, and most especially, we're so glad that you're really working among the poor. You know, the church in history always inclines itself to the poor. And even now, that is the call of Vatican II and also part of our archdiocese and where I also came from with Bishop Labayen, we always emphasize our desire to become Church of the Poor, you know. And I'm so happy to have you, sister, and also your group precisely working about and with the poor of all diocese. What exactly, sister, can you tell our watchers and listeners about your ministry? What are you doing?
Well, sister, before you answer perhaps the question of Archbishop, you were once popularly known as the MOP Sisters. And then lately, your congregation was changed to Compassionate Franciscan Sisters of the Poor. Please tell us a little about your history?
Yes. Our congregation was started by Father Holong.
Oh, yeah. The father of the missionaries of the Poor.
Famous Father Holong, yeah.
Yes. He started the Missionaries of the Poor Brothers. And I was in Jamaica when the brothers were started. And they used to come over to our school and go to the beach and have holidays and so on. When I retired from teaching...
In Jamaica.
I went to work with the United Nations, with the refugees, UNHCR, with the United Nations High Commission for Refugees. And I took care of the Haitians and the Cubans who were coming to Jamaica as refugees. And then I retired from that. The Haitians went back and the Cubans went back to Cuba. And then our group there was closed, that United Nations group was closed right there. And so I retired from that. I had just retired from being teaching in the high school for 60 years. I was a head teacher.
What a feat, 60 years.
Principal for 25 years. So I retired and Father said, would you come and teach the brothers?
Yes.
Certainly I went. So I used to work with the brothers in Jamaica. And then there were some sisters here
in the Philippines.
The Philippines, yes. Father, Louis probably knows. But there were five sisters and they had started a group, but they couldn't get off the ground.
ISIS.
What is the name of this group, sister?
The Missionaries of the Poor Sisters.
These are local ladies.
Group,
huh?
But it was started by the name of Missionary Sisters of St. Francis, I think.
Okay.
That's why you were sent to the Philippines to head this group of MOP sisters.
That is
correct.
Ah, okay.
When was that, sister?
To me, this was in 1997.
Oh, so you're staying in Naga City for almost 15 years?
Well, I was in Jamaica. And then I came here in 1999. That's when I came here. Started, yes. So we were under the auspices, as it were, of the brothers, Brothers of the Poor. So we started our own group, as I told Bishop when he first came, that we were in a Bahay Kubo.
Yeah, you know, in Dayangdam.
In Dayangdam. It's now renovated. But we started, we got off the ground, and then we started to send missionaries to Jamaica and missionaries to Haiti, even to Malabon. We have a convent there with the Katmon. Used to be Basurahan there. Mm-hmm. And we really grew and grew. And I went down to Jamaica one year, and Father Holong came up and said, Mother, I would prefer if you don't use our name again. missionaries are poor. I was somewhat disappointed, but I said, that's okay, Father. So I came back and I told Archbishop Legazpi, I said, Archbishop, we're no longer missionaries of the poor sisters, MOP yeah. sisters. He said, don't worry, Mother. You are now under my jurisdiction. You obey me. You don't have to obey Father yeah. anymore. So we went on and on and on. Then finally, Archbishop Legazpi said, we'll have to have rules to follow. So I wrote a constitution. I wrote yeah. a set of constitutions, which was approved in 2009, just approved. And we started on our own. And yeah. then Archbishop said, in order to be really recognized, you have to get permission from the Pope. So I was a Franciscan sister of Allegheny. Our foundation, our group is in Allegheny. We're over 100 years old, Allegheny, New York.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And so I wrote a letter to the
Vatican. Okay. It was approved.
It was approved yeah. within 2 weeks. He sent back and said, you're free. So we really came to work with the poor, yeah. Bishop. With the poor, completely with the poor.
And that time your name has been changed to what? Sisters of Franciscan?
Compassion.
No.
At the time of the approval of the constitutions,
yes.
we were given the name Compassionate Franciscan Sisters of the Poor. Actually, I didn't choose it. We went to DSWD and we have a distribution center, as you
yeah.
know,
yeah.
where we get all sorts of goods to give to the poor. And the lady at the DSWD, forget her name, she said, what name are you going to use now because you're no longer missionaries
yes,
of the poor?
Because you're a known MOP.
Yes, as MOP.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't like it anyway because it was MOP, comma, sisters. I said MOP, comma, sisters. So the lady at the office said, what about Franciscan Sister of the Poor? And she said, the other one, no, no, it's too close to another name, another order. So the lady suggested, what about Compassionate Franciscan
yeah,
Sister of the
I think
Poor?
That's better, yeah.
It was very much better. And our secretary of the board, she said, I like that. So it was approved by
yeah.
the board and by the Archbishop.
How many are you now, sister?
We are right now. 27, I think.
You also have aspirant sister, a continuing formation
yeah, we have,
of the sister.
We have some
sister.
And you have houses.
Now with us.
You have houses also in Manila?
We have one house in Malabon.
Mm-hmm. Malabon.
Which is Queen of Hope.
Okay.
Yeah, right at next door to the Katmun.
Mm-hmm.
Surahan.
Mm-hmm.
And
I
then,
see.
Yeah, we have a daycare center and a little school there. And we have apostolates for the poor.
But you also have sisters abroad now, missionary
sisters? Oh,
yes,
we have.
In Jamaica.
In Jamaica, we have the HIV hospice run by Sister Myrna, who is a nurse from here.
From Naga.
From Naga. She runs the hospice, which takes care of
the
patients.
With HIV.
Yes.
You know,
or dying.
You know, sister, this program, Kamusta po, Bishop, how are you, Bishop, is also a venue or a means wherein we let our audience watch us know the many congregations working. And this also serves as a vocation promotion for the sisters. Huh?
Yes.
And so, for all you know, someone might be listening who would be very much interested in joining your group. If ever they do, where can they contact your sister?
Right here in Naga, we just, if you write to the Compassionate Franciscan Sister of the Poor, it will get to us.
Yes,
but that
yes.
would be so
Naga
nice.
City?
Naga City.
Okay.
Naga City, 4400 Philippines.
Okay.
At for the information ng lahat nating mga tagapanood at tagapakinig sa Kumusta Po Bishop, sila pa din po yung dating nakasuot na parang si Mother Teresa. So, kanina lang kasi, kiniklear ko kay sister na sabi ko, ang akala ko kasi naka-brown si sister, akala ko sa kanya ay Carmelite.
Opo. No.
Yung mga sisters nila, Bishop, sila pa rin po yung nakasuot ng abito na slight Mother Teresa. Yes po.
Mother. Yeah, sort of. Yes.
Ah, before you were like worried that one, no? Kasi yung group ni Mother Teresa, it's the missionaries of charity. Missionaries of charity. And they are staying near the Carmelite nuns.
Yes,
alam mo, sister, The Archdiocese is very blessed. Huh? We have contemplatives here. We have active sisters here. Mm-hmm. We have sisters involved in education, sisters involved in health, sisters involved with among children, orphanage, you know. Mm-hmm. And this is really a very blessed Archdiocese. Yes. You know? I mean, it only shows that our Blessed Mother, our Blessed Mother, like a true mother, looks after really our poor children.
Yes.
And you know, during this time, the Franciscans are really very popular. Because our Pope is St. Francis.
Huh?
But you know, before we continue asking sisters some questions and getting to know her and her congregation, let's have a break. Pagpulit yung alis, mga kapanood, babalik po kami tayo sa ating programa.
Kamusta po, Bisho? Bisho!
Kumusta po, Bishop is also brought to you by Bob Marlin Restaurant, Goldprint Publishing House, Starmark Royal, Moraville Hotel and Restaurant,
Deca Homes,
Ateneo de Naga University. We appeal to our listeners and viewers to support this project. Please send your donation to the Archbishop's residence or the CCCOM office, 473-8483-472-5665.
The Lord has blessed us with a new Holy Father. But who is he? Where does he come from? What's he like? Jorge Mario Bergoglio. He was born in Buenos Aires, Argentina on December 17, 1936. His dad was a railway worker, mom a housewife. Together they raised Jorge and his four brothers. He wanted to study chemistry and worked hard to get a master's at the University of Buenos Aires. Then he made a change in plans. So at the age of 21, he entered into a Jesuit seminary. And after years of study and prayer, he was ordained a priest. As a priest, he welcomed a life full of happiness, and he has been able to help others in so many ways. In addition to administering the sacraments, he has been a teacher, a guide for young Jesuits, and yes, till this day, a great lover of soccer. His favorite team is Argentinian club San Lorenzo. After a few years, his community asked him to serve his brothers as provincial superior, then as rector of the seminary. And if you think that's a lot, then God called him to become a bishop. And while his responsibilities grew and grew, he knew that the best way to serve was to be humble, to stay close to the Lord in prayer, and to be faithful to the church. His road has not been without difficulties for sure. Many times he has had to endure insults and misunderstandings. Still, true love always requires sacrifice. Did I mention that he does all this with just one functioning lung? After needing to have part of one of his lungs removed as a teenager, he knew that the Holy Spirit would have to do the extra breathing for him. After a few years of being bishop, when he thought that was a lot, the Holy Father, John Paul II, made him a cardinal, an important job with all sorts of tasks. Although many may have some strange ideas about a cardinal's life, for him, many things remained the same. He lived in a simple apartment, he continued to cook for himself, and he even used the subway instead of a chauffeur. He knew that the best way to serve was to be close to the people he loved, accompanying them in their daily tasks. And finally, if you think that's a lot, just a short time ago, Christ asked of Jorge one more big step of faith, that he become his vicar on earth, that he give his life in service to the Universal Church as the Holy Father. An intimidating request, no doubt. But as we have seen, Jorge had trusted in the Lord his whole life, through the hard times and the good times. He had always striven to say yes to the Lord. And he wasn't going to stop now. So with a heart full of faith, Jorge accepted the Lord's call, leaving family, friends, and country behind. He took on a new name, Francis, a new home, Rome, and a new mission, being the Pope. All for love, love for Christ, and love for us.
Kumusta po, Bishop, is brought to you by the Archdiocese of Cáceres, Cáceres Commission on Communications, Cáceres Renewal Communities, PBN-TV5 DZOK 97.5, GNN Naga Channel 48, 98.3 FM The Mother's Touch, 24K Jewelry and Pawn Shop, FINMA Foundation, University of Northeastern Philippines.
Nakaka-inspirar po ang sa tuyang pinag-uurulayan na istorya. Hali po sa compassionate Franciscan Sisters of the Poor, or popularly known as po kaito na Missionaries of the Poor Sisters. Papadagos po kita kan sa tuyang kahaputan kay Mother Joan Claire. Mother Joan, some of the programs that you have had here in the Philippines is the wheelchair program. Can you tell us something about this wheelchair program? Is it ongoing, and how many recipients do we have already?
It really is ongoing, but it just started not too long ago.
Okay.
And it is run by the Knights of Columbus, especially in California.
So it's in partnership with the Knights of Columbus, yeah. Huh?
They run it actually. Well, it's the American Wheelchair Mission.
Yes.
And Jared Lewis's son, as you know.
Oh, yeah.
But it's true. It's really sponsored. It's supported by the Knights of Columbus.
Okay.
And all the members who come are Knights of Columbus. But they have given about 3,000 to 4,000 wheelchairs already.
Already in the Philippines?
Yes.
In Naga?
In the Philippines.
In the Philippines. General,
because we go to Malabon, we go to Manila also. And other places. In Davao we were this year. So it has been in the Philippines in general, but 3,000 to 4,000. But they hope to continue. As a matter of fact, they hope to expand. And it will go on. That's why I try to reach different parishes here in the Philippines, here in Naga.
So you have the top parishes in the Archdiocese.
Yes, I speak to the pastors.
Yes,
would you like to have a distribution in your church? So, for example, Immaculate Conception, or I will go now to Cathedral and different places, and would you like to have a distribution? So they get their parishioners who are disabled to come. And there might be a mass, and there's a distribution, and they take pictures.
So right now you have a continuing program, the wheelchair.
Yes, definitely.
Sister, tell me, aside from that, do you also have centers, or do you go to parishes wherein you take care of some poor kids and
children,
families?
You mean with the wheelchairs, Bishop?
Not necessarily a wheelchair, but other programs.
Yes, we have. That's why we have. I had to on the paper, because there are so many.
Okay.
We
Tess.
You saw the squatters, about 26 families come every Saturday morning, and we give them rice for the week, and we feed them right there, and give them different clothing and candy and biscuits and so on. 26, that's one, but we have in Balatas, Basurahan, we go there. They're fed every day. Every day. They're fed, and we have a little school.
Imagine every day,
every day
feeding.
We have a support for that, a grant. The people came and we took them there, and they saw and said, "We only, Dr. Joel, we only go MWF."
Yes.
Okay. So he went back, and when he saw the people there coming, just eating and getting the clothing and just grabbing whatever they could get, they went back and they said, they sent me a grant, and they said, "Feed them every day." Except, so we feed them Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, every day except Saturday.
How many of them? How many families?
There are now about 34 families. When we started with the Missionaries of the Poor Brothers, MOP Brothers, there were 11 families. Now there are about 34
they
families.
They go to your places, or you go to their
places? No, we go. I built a little Baha'i Kubo for them. It's sort of a multi-purpose. We say Mass there, and even brothers and fathers come down and say Mass there. Once a week, and we feed them every day. I have a little school, and there's a teacher, a paid teacher, and somebody who cooks the lugao or the champurrado, every day. And we go up, the sisters go up, we go up, they say the rosary, and they say the Senegal prayer, and we try to get them to do baptisms and their confirmations, and I even used to drive them to to Basilica de Mass on Sundays, but I can't do that anymore.
They're anyway, sister, I'll be very happy to visit your place.
Yes,
you know?
Yes.
I'm new in here in the Archdiocese, and I've been moving around. Sure. At the moment, parishes. I've been visiting parishes, and well, actually, what I did mean is to go also to centers wherein the poor are being cared for. No?
Welcome,
I've been
Bishop.
To MOPs and the Missionary Sisters, and I'll be delighted to visit you.
They'll
also.
Be so happy to see
yeah,
you.
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
They've never seen a bishop.
That is one of my advocacies also. Really, we have to look after our young children.
We go up every day. Wonderful.
And when you
day.
Visit them, Archbishop, you asked for lots of books.
Ah, yeah.
Fond memories I have had with you, sister, is that I have to get a lot of hardbound books, beautiful books, not for resale books coming from the U.S.,
yes.
and you can get as many as you
yeah,
want.
Yes, exactly. Yes.
I have Normally a library
I get,
coming.
Yeah, I have. I connect with some schools and ask for
yes.
school supplies,
yes.
and I give books also. And when in my other diocese, I also do that. I get ball pens. You know.
Yes.
In fact, when I travel now, I always bring ball pen, lollipops and ball pens.
Yes.
I think
especially in the morning.
Your
in the morning, I see students, so I give them out.
I had to do a list because there's so many. We get food, medicine,
yes.
medical supplies,
yes,
medical
books.
Equipment, educational
yeah.
books, prosthesis, walking aids.
Napaka-expensive.
We had two containers. Maybe Bishop can help us now. We had two containers of seeds to come,
seeds.
And they would not release it. Seeds could plant all of they plant industry or some department would not allow it in.
Yeah, because there are certain quarantine possible. We really do not know, but we have to find out. So
he
we might
would
be able.
Visited one of the men, Mr. Luxon or something, said he would allow. He said, I'd go and examine it myself and said, but they didn't give us the permit. So they probably had to throw it in the sea. But you get seeds. Musical instruments, equipment, household goods, orphanage supplies, toys, books, as you said.
Well, that shows that, you know,
yes.
when a congregation or of a group of sisters are really doing their work, you know, there are many who are more than willing to help.
More than willing to help.
So just mentioning this sister, it really gives
a
picture of how
support.
Active your congregation
yes.
is. Huh?
Yeah. Very extensive bishop support.
Yes. You also look after children with ill maladies, with sickness, with disabilities. You look after them. Yeah. Huh?
Yes, we have an orphanage too in Pakol. Queen of Peace,
Children's
Home. I like to call it Children's Home.
Yeah.
So I feel it's a home, not an orphanage.
That's
there
right.
you really house abandoned children.
Yes.
And then...
We also... Sister Venice is so good. She's a social worker. She studied social work. And she is now able to get these children adopted. We have children in Spain,
yes.
Rome,
and they're
Italy,
the orphans?
Australia, abandoned. They have to be abandoned in order to be adopted.
I mean they're brought out, sister.
Yes, the parents come, the adoptive parents come for them.
Yeah.
These children actually are up for adoption, Bishop. And
yeah, but you have to go all through the process of papers, legal,
the
process.
And
yeah.
Well, no, sister, I wish you would have more time, no? But later on, most probably, we would invite you again, because you're a very interesting guest, not just guest, but co-worker in our Archdiocese, and we're very fortunate really to have you with us, and wonderful that you've explained to us what you undertake, you were doing, and I'm sure there are many of our young ladies or families who are more than interested to assist you and to be partner with you, to join us, sister.
And not only just to go to Jamaica, to go to Haiti,
yes,
but to work here.
Yeah, precisely. I'm so happy that really here we have to work here.
And then they might get to feel like a celebrity too.
Amen. That's right. No.
Thank you for having me.
Kulang man sa init in pagpadangat kan sa indang familia, inihinipnoan kan mga madre sa Queen of Peace Children's Home. Inian naging kapaladan kan mga angki, naan kadaklan binayaan na kan sa indang sariring familia, igwaman ni mga temporaryo sanaan pag-istarig day, sangkod na masing magana ang pangangaipo kan sa indang salon.
Pagminsan po, pagminsan kasi naghihiri lang sila, pero hindi naman yung hilang na grabe yung mga kalintura lang or pagminsan may mga sipon.
Ini naman ang buhay na pinili kan mga missionary of the Four Sisters ang magserbing magurang, tugang, asin ka familia kan mga aki. Bakong madali alagad bagay na udok sa botin dang itinatao sa mga kaakian.
Nagtitimpla kami ng mga gatas ng baby, nagbibigay sa kanila. And then kapag umiiyak, syempre kailangan kargahin kasi para tumigil.
Katuwang man kan mga MOP sisters ang mga volunteer caregivers as in social workers.
So ako nag-ibong ang mga case study nila. And si mga dating iguan ng case study, nag-a-update ako. So yun yung pang-role ko. And bako lang siya, nagka-counseling sa mga, kasi may mga bigger children kami dito. So they need counseling, syempre. Kasi iba't ibang families in the highly, iba't ibang background. So iba't ibang experiences na kaipo ang heal.
Sa presente, ang Queen of Peace Children's Home, iyo ang nagsiserbing harong kan mga aking ini. Dahil maninda aram ang sa indang pinaghalian, ang importante, nakakuasindan ni Staran na maapod nindang harong ng pagkamo.
Kumusta po, Bishop is also brought to you by Bob Marlin Restaurant, Goldprint Publishing House, Starmark Royal, Moraville Hotel and Restaurant,
Deca Homes,
Ateneo de Naga University. We appeal to our listeners and viewers to support this project. Please send your donation to the Archbishop's residence or the CCCOM office, 473-8483-472-5665.
This is the home of Our Lady of Peñafrancha in the pilgrim city of Naga in the Bicol region. Every September, people from all places visit this Marian city to venerate the miraculous image of Ina. In the year 2010, we have celebrated the tercentenary or the 300th year of our devotion to her. We rejoiced, we celebrated, and we made a vow to continue our devotion and share it to our future generations. We need to pass our devotion to our children and even to our non-Bicolano brothers and sisters. But how can we do this? Last 2012, the Basilica, through the leadership of Monsignor Odel Cajot, started a noble project, a Museo de Nuestra Señora de Peñafrancha. It will house the memories of our Ina's enduring love to her children. There we will see auditorium, diorama, galleries, and al fresco. Let us support to realize this 20 million project of building the museo as our gift to our mother, our Ina, Our Lady of Peñafrancha. For your donations, send to the Peñafrancha Basilica Office, Balatas Road, Naga City, Philippines. Telephone number 473-3644.
Kumusta po, Bishop? Is brought to you by the Archdiocese of Caceres, Caceres Commission on Communications, Caceres Renewal Communities, PBN-TV 5 DZOK 97.5, GNN Naga Channel 48, 98.3 FM The Mother's Touch, 24K Jewelry and Pawn Shop, FINMA Foundation, University of Northeastern Philippines.
Maswerte pong maray ang sa tuyang archdiocese dahil igwa po kita ng mga kongregasyon na arog kang pikisplikar sa tuya na sa tuyang bisita mo niya na aldaw. Thank you very much to Mother Joanne Claire Chen Loy, kan Compassionate Franciscan Sisters of the Poor. Mga tugang saro na naman na edisyon ang sa inyong nadalan digdi po sa tuyang TV program na ini. Sa liwat, iba na nindugiraray kami sa samuyang pangungumusta sa satuyang Arsobispo Can Caceres. Salamat po sa samuyang mga sponsors na padagos nagsusuporta sa programang ini. Liwat, ako po si Tess Banyares Delphine. Diyos mabalos kan sa indong padagos na pag-antabay.
I would like to say a word of thanks to Archbishop for inviting me here and having me to speak. And Tess,
thank you
very, very much. You did so well. I'm really edified because this program, I hope, will bring help to the Archdiocese, and I hope some sisters to our congregation. We are the Compassionate Franciscan Sisters of the Poor. We need more sisters to help because our work is very big, it's large, it's extensive, and we'd like some more people to help. There's so many poor in the Philippines and we need to spread out. So thank you very, very much.
Thank you, sister. God bless
you. It was a pleasure to be with you. Thank you.
Mga tugang, nagpa-aram na si Tess, si sister, ako man magpa-aram na si Magabos. Anyway, itong paalam na ito'y pansamantala lamang because I hope next Sunday, makikita muli tayo. Kaya nagpapasalamat ako sa inyo. Ding pakikisa sa amin sa aming programa at napapasalamat ako sa ating sister Edeline na sa pamamagitan niya ay nakakapag-communicate din tayo sa ating mga kapatid na ito. So muli po, maraming salamat. Huwag niyo kalilimutan na yung bispo ay talagang interesado sa inyong buhay. Kaya namimibi ako, nananalangin ako, magpalaik kayo ng Panginoon. Diyos mabalos, God bless you. Maraming salamat.
At makipagkwentuhan ka na. Kumusta po, Bishop? Kumusta?
Kumusta po, Bishop is also brought to you by Bob Marlin Restaurant, Gold Print Publishing House, Starmark Royal, Moraville Hotel and Restaurant,
Deca Homes,
Ateneo de Naga University. We appeal to our listeners and viewers to support this project. Please send your donation to the Archbishop's residence or the CCCOM office 473-8483-472-5665.